Yes. Happy birthday to you. And happy birthday to me. In fact, happy birthday to us all. It's kind of that amazing day for me, and I simply want to embrace it, even though it's not really my birthday. Now, this is getting confusing, isn't it? Happy birthday to me, and it's not my birthday. What do I mean by that? And happy birthday to you, and there's a good chance it's not your birthday. Well, we're going to do a little of what I call stray learning today, and from that, I think we're going to have a little bit of fun. It is the Jesus Entrepreneur Experience from the Christian Entrepreneur Network, and we're here to help you figure out how in the year ahead of you, you can make it a year that is truly one of the best ever. Let's see if we can start to do that. It's 2 weeks till the year begins and this year ends. We're going to take some time to make it all worthwhile. I'm Stan Houston, and the program, the Jesus Entrepreneur Experience, with all kinds of good stories and fun for you, it begins right now. And indeed it does. First of all, it is a happy birthday for me, but it's not about me. It's about somebody who's very near and dear to me. Let me tell you the story. It is December 18th, 1909, and in the cold, wintry, almost prairie, almost pioneer days in Minnesota, a gentleman named Orville Johnson was born to a immigrant Swedish family, and Orville Johnson then went on to become, as I oftentimes say, one of the finest men I've ever met. Orville Johnson was a talented and hard-working farmer, was so good the Chicago Cubs thought about trying to make him into a baseball player, but he followed through and did a number of entrepreneurial things, and then he did what he was made to do. He went into the ministry and he became a pastor, a preacher, and more than that, somebody who led and influenced lives all of his life. Incredible man. And then, on a warm, wonderful day in May in 1947, he had his third child and his first daughter, and her name was Karen. Karen! And in that all-Swedish family, Karen grew up, and some years later, I was able to meet her, and I kind of knew right away that if this was the girl who would take me, I was really going to marry above myself. But she said yes, and that was, wow, over 50-some years ago. So if it hadn't been for that wonderful birthday in December 18th, 1909, there's a very, very good chance that my life would been and be extremely different and not nearly as blessed as it has been. So truly, December 18th, 1909 is a happy birthday day for me. And perhaps one of the fun things to do as an entrepreneur, as a Christian gentleman, Christian gentlewoman, is to do just that thing, to celebrate not only your own birthday, but to honor and celebrate the birthdays of people who've meant a great deal to you. Just think about that as you think about ways to make a little bit of difference in the world. Well, that's part of the story, and that's part of the tip, but I also got something that said, "Happy birthday, everyone." Now, I want you to listen to this because this is kind of fun, all right? Now, listen to this. My friend, another Christian entrepreneur, Al Paulson, and boy, does he have stories to tell. And Al is a good friend and a former client, and I guess all of my former clients are still kind of clientele and good friends. And he said, "Stan, this is strange, but it worked for me. I tried it on several folks over the weekend, and it all came out the same. Amazing. Happy birthday, everyone. We are all 2018 this year. The whole world is the same age. It happens only once every 1,000 years. Okay, here's what he says. Add your age. Okay, take your age and add it to the year of your birth. All right, you got that? And the answer will be 2018. Take your age right now, add it to the year of your birth, and it will come to 2018. This is true for everyone. It is both strange and inexplicable. Try it and see. It will not happen again for another 1,000 years. Now, why does that work? Well, why don't you try it and see how well it works for you? Now, there's more to it than my two stories. Please keep in mind that as Christian entrepreneurs, as men and women of the faith, we are called to be interesting, attractive people. I remember something that changed my life a number of years ago when I was doing international Christian missionary broadcasting, and we were doing a good job of that. One day I got a letter from a guy in Jamaica who confessed that he liked the program, but then he said, and it changed my whole experience, he says, "But don't you guys ever talk about anything but God?" That's good. That's nice. But do you have any other interests in life? Well, of course we did. But I discovered that I was not communicating what was fully me and what would make me perhaps more interesting and attractive and useful and helpful to people. Yeah, the God talk and the lessons of the Spirit were certainly important. But do I have any other interests? Are there anything else that I could share with others that might be fun, unusual, helpful, insightful? And that's what I learned, that not only as a broadcaster I had to have many interests besides the subject matter on the radio, it also meant that as a Christian man I should cultivate interests in so many other things that do two things. First of all, they help me take my calling or my idea or my life less seriously because I think about other people and other things. At the same time, it gives me a way to converse and think and perhaps connect with people who have many other diverse interests. And so, it not only is good missionary work, it's really very good marketing work. I know that one of the more successful entrepreneurs that I know, he loves to talk about his business, but he basically doesn't very much. What he talks about are other people's business, and he certainly asks them about their business. He'll talk about his own, but he shows that attractive, you know, smile, interest, presence to other people. And so, even though he's got a story to tell and he needs to tell it, that's how he does his marketing, and that's how someone else, she does her marketing. It's all about telling good stories, but it also is about listening to other people's stories and finding out what you can about them and their life. And sometime this week, we're going to talk about the seven things you'd like to know about your prospects. Seven things you'd like to know about your client or customer that'll really help you in your place and your space and your work in the marketplace. That's coming up. That's a bit of a tease, as we say. So there we go. I'd like you to think about it. Hey, have fun with that now. Go around and tell people about that and see what kind of conversations it might lead to. You know, well, when were you born? Who knows where it leads? And you become a person who's interested in others. You're a person who's connected to others. And you're a person with some clever, what I oftentimes say, just some stray knowledge, just some interesting facts and figures that bring you with a smile into the life of others. And remember, all good marketing and all good personal marketing makes people smile. Well, I hope right now you're taking just a few minutes to smile. I'm Stan Houston. This is the Jesus Entrepreneur Experience, and we'll be right back. And we are. Well, here we go, just a few minutes more. This is a podcast. It is internet on-demand radio. Now, a couple things. First of all, I try to have this program 2-3 times a week, maybe 4, but it's been a full week since I had that conversation with Chal. And go back and listen to it. Now, two things. First of all, because it's on-demand radio, I can do it whenever I want. And rather than having it every day the same, no matter what, my challenge has been, Stan, unless you have something really important to say, perhaps you should just stay off the air that day. If it's not particularly useful, practical, or helpful, maybe you should just be quiet and reduce the noise in the world. And that may be part of it. But part of the reason I didn't have anything to say is because I was so busy. I had people from all over the world asking me to do video spokesperson and video commercials for their business, which is part of what I do as a part of my work as a business performance coach and as the leader of the Christian Entrepreneur Network. So I had a number of people who were on the line from all over the world, and they were asking me to do what I can do for you. Not only did I coach them and help them on what a good 60-second commercial could be, what it would be a good presentation. See, they wanted something audio or visual or both to put on the internet to help build their business. They now know that just having text and blogging is not enough. Podcast radio is growing. The internet channels of obviously, YouTube and the video channels and the multitude of audio channels are going and growing. And if you're going to do business today, it better be something that has some spokesperson talk to it. It better have lively people. It has to have energy and performance and movement and color. It needs to be radio or television or perhaps both. And so I was busy doing that for a number of businesses, and I can probably do it for your business too. So there's a little bit of self-promotion, but whether you hire me or not, you need to be thinking about, in 2019, whatever you were doing to market your business will probably change. You're going to have to learn how to use the new mass media, the modern media, not just the social media, but the modern media. You're going to have to learn how to be a performer, a demonstrator. You're going to have to be a world-class storyteller. And you're going to have to learn how to, with a smile, to promote your business, to actually help people want to buy your stuff and your service and your good name and your reputation. And, they don't like to be sold, but if it's good and if it's valuable, they'll perhaps want to buy it. So I want you to think about that. We would be glad to help you, give you some counsel or advice on how you might do your marketing and your media differently in 2019. Now check us out at the website, tcenglobal.org. tcenglobal.org, or you can reach out to me very simply, Stan Houston, S-T-A-N-H-U-S-T-A-D, put it together, at gmail.com, stanhouston@gmail.com, and say, Stan, tell me more, and about how I should do my business differently in terms of marketing and storytelling and promoting. How can you help me as a Christian entrepreneur, not only to market my business well, but perhaps to claim and show my faith and put it all together to make my life and my business more attractive to people so that they will want to do business with me and perhaps come to know me and even give me a chance to talk about the master entrepreneur himself from time to time, when it's appropriate, when it works, when it's right. We'd be glad to help you do just that. So once again, stanhouston@gmail.com. stanhouston@gmail.com. Okay, the lesson for the day. You got to be interesting. You got to be funny. You perhaps have to have things in your life that just cause people to smile and enjoy being in touch with you. So there we go. There's my tribute to that very important man, why it's truly a happy birthday day for me, and why I celebrate this day profoundly. And then have some fun. 2018. Everybody, it works out. How does that happen? Why does that happen? I'd love to hear from you. And then think about how you will honor people by just simply celebrating their birthdays. Even though it's not yours, but it's a birthday that meant something to you. And a note, a letter, an email, perhaps a phone call, just to make that known to yourself and to others. I'm Stan Husted. I hope that we will be able to have some conversations. This is going to be significant for me and for you in the year ahead. By the way, I'd love if you'd like to know more about how this is going to work for you. I'd love to talk to you again about that. Again, stanhouston.com. If this is helpful to you, I would ask you to think about perhaps helping to keep us on the air. It's tcenglobal.org/contribute now. tcenglobal.org/contribute now. And that'll help keep us on the air and keep us in touch with you. And I would be grateful. Indeed, it's 2 weeks till the end of the year and 2 weeks till the start of the new year. We've got much to enjoy and celebrate as we are in the Christmas and New Year's season, but there's also much to think about, pray about, and plan about so that the year ahead of us will truly be a year in which we can bless others and perhaps find the same things coming back to us. And that we will be a year that we serve others and that we flourish in what we do. Keep in touch. This is the Jesus Entrepreneur Experience, and we'll be around from time to time in the next 2 weeks and hopefully throughout 2019, and you'll be on the program too. I'm looking forward to that. All the best, and bye for now.